Hi there, gang. My name is Dr. Jay Breitling with New Leaf Chiropractic. And as I'm recording this, I get a lot of questions in our office that are seasonal. Hey, my back hurts today because I was gardening. My back hurts today because I was shoveling. My back hurts today because it was raking. Those are three of the most common questions that we get with the seasons. So I want to take this opportunity to talk about what you can do for each of those, because in the middle of winter, you're not gardening. In the middle of summer, you're probably not doing a whole lot of shoveling. The biggest thing with shoveling, first and foremost, is to remember that it's cold outside. And you don't really need a reminder when you go outside because it's freezing. In summer, you might need a reminder that your body is cold. So the first thing that I want to remind everybody before they get started is to warm up. Whether you're gardening, whether you're raking, whether you're shoveling, the first thing is to make sure that you get your body nice and warm beforehand. This morning, actually, we had some snow on the ground, and my way to warm up was to get out and actually go for a half an hour run before I shoveled in the driveway. So this is going to be my tool for talking about proper form, but if it's light and outside or light snow, or you're doing light work, it's really important that you choose something that's lighter instead of heavier. So in addition to warming up, make sure that you've got the right tools. Yeah, if it's just a little bit of light snow, you probably don't need to get the big old the steel tip to the real heavy shovels that break up ice. You probably don't need one of those. First thing we do at the office here when it starts to snow, we just get out the little broom and we try to just push away as much of the light snow as possible. Just don't necessarily need to get warmed up for something like that. So make sure you choose the right tool. If it's summer and you're gardening, remember, again, that your body's cold. To get a nice little outdoor yoga in the sun, we think would be a really, really wise choice for warming up. You could just do some regular stretches in the backyard if you're gonna do some raking. You've got something that you can hold on to. Just get in and do a little bit of light hamstring and quad stretching like this. You'd be surprised how just a little bit of warming up like this actually goes a long way. Most of the things that you do in the garden or with shoveling are going to be involving the Roman deadlift or the deadlift form. So we just even a little bit of stretching where you're doing something like this, and I'll use my trusty assistant in a moment, just to warm up your back, warm up your hamstrings so you don't pull something, is a really, really wise idea. Can I use you, Marissa?
Uh-huh.
So go ahead and give me a proper like deadlift form. Touch your toes. Good, so a couple issues with Larissa right now. You saw her with her rounded back, so give me even a more pronounced rounded back, Larissa. You wanna stay out of any form that looks like this, whether you're picking up the shovel, whether you're gardening, stay away from any rounded form like this. So go and give me some good form. There you go. Generally speaking, you want to have straight, not rounded surfaces. So if you're shoveling, go ahead and give me a good shovel there, Larissa. So you see she's got pretty nice straight form there, but we have a tendency when the snow gets heavy to round forward and to lift and pull. Yeah, so what we want to do when you're shoveling, the proper way to shovel, is make sure you're using your legs. We talked about the deadlift form, find yourself shoveling, that you're not using your back, but instead, as much as you can, you're using your legs. Always keeping your back straight, but the more you can use your legs when you're shoveling to get low, the better, which is why it's really, really important to warm up when you're shoveling. Same thing goes for gardening, same thing goes for raking. Beautiful sunny day in October, find yourself outside raking. Really important that you get out there and you're not just doing a whole bunch of this. We see it all the time, that rounded back, people are trying to think, no, just choose the right rake, whether it's metal, and just nice measured strokes, get your pile. You don't need to be dragging a whole bunch of leaves, you don't need to be dragging a whole bunch of snow one time. Hope you found this video useful. Right tools, warm up, proper form. Thanks for tuning in.